Hi, welcome back to another tutorial where we're going to discuss the blower motor. In the other video, we discussed this part of it, the primary circuit with opens and shorts. We're going to continue now with the resistor part of it, the blower motor resistor part of it. So this is at a request of a viewer who sent me a comment. I think his name was Sahil, if I have it properly announced. Anyway, I'd like to thank also Arthur, another viewer, for his compliments. And before we begin, I just want to make sure that you are familiar with the blower motor, which is the fan motor in your vehicle. Whenever you put, this is the switch. This is whenever you put the air conditioning on, or you put the defroster on, or you put the vents on for heat for anything, you have a choice. You always have a choice of putting the blower motor on at certain speeds. For this vehicle, for GM's, it's low speed, it's medium one, medium two, and a high speed. Obviously, the highest speed will be at, or the fan blower will be at the high speed. The lowest will be at the low, obviously. Now, here's the rule. For the high speed, the blower motor will get the most voltage. If there's 12 volts, which there is, it'll get 12 volts. That's how it gets the full speed, the high speed. Of course, now at the low speed, going at the other part of the spectrum, you expect it to get the lowest voltage. So the highest voltage for the highest speed, the lowest voltage for the lowest speed, which is attributed to a series resistor circuit over here, which is in series with the blower motor, the fan motor we call it, now, which is next to the firewall. Now, this is a complicated circuit. I remember I went over one time quite a while ago. I don't remember which video it was, but like I said, I'll go over it and step by step. So like we said, we have a choice when this switch that we choose on the dashboard, let's say we're going to put on maximum AC. Okay, so we connect it through this one, a fuse block. It's called HVAC fuse F6, rated at a fuse 9 actually, rated at 20 amps. Now, a brown wire comes through here, comes through the switch in any position chosen by the driver or the passenger. So this current flows, let's say for us, if we put it on maximum AC, we follow this line, this dot, and therefore this now will be on this one, maximum AC. This is the off position, this is the maximum AC position, and this is the norm position. So when we choose for ourselves maximum AC, air conditioning, we flip the switch to this side. Follow it, follow it, follow it. We have a splice here, a node, but guess what? If this switch is in this position, that means it's not in this position. So we cannot go from here to here. We cannot go from here to here. The only choice we can go is from here to here to here. All others have no connection because the switch now is flipped in only one. It can only be flipped in one position at one time. And we chose that one by saying maximum AC. So we follow this one here, 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 through C2, connected C2, through the brown wire again. Now comes the tricky part. This is the tricky part. We have a choice over here. What did we put? We know we put the selector, the mode switch for maximum AC. What did we put for the blower motor setting? Do we put high? Do we put low? Do we put medium one, medium two? Let's say we started on low. It's always on low, regardless. If you go here, we continue here, follow the yellow, the brown wire. Now, if we go, if this is on the low position, same theory is involved. Now the switch is in this position, right? So we're going to say, okay, current can flow from the brown wire through C4, through here, but guess what? Terminal D not used in this circuit. So that means current cannot flow here. This switch is only in this position. We left it on low, okay? Since we left it on low position, we can't use this connection over here. What do we do need? We go here, brown, brown, going through a connector CTO3, a plug P100, going through over here, and the brown wire again, terminal. Now, this is in a unit. All these resistors that you see are located in a unit. So let's say we're going to go terminal B. This resistor is for the low setting, for low, when this is a low. This one is for medium one. This is for medium two. So we follow the line. We're not going to go back up here because remember why? The switch is in this position. The switch is not in this position. We're going to follow here. We're going to follow here. Why don't we go up here? Because again, the switch is in this position. This is open. We go over here. We went through our first resistor in the low position. We went through our second resistor. Now we're going through our third resistor. And what's happening as we do those things? We're losing voltage. This has a voltage drop across it. This has another voltage drop added to this one. This has another voltage drop added to these two. We're losing voltage. Also, the current is being decreased because the resistance is being at more resistance, less current. So now we come over here. We come here. Follow the yellow. Here comes a difficult part. Here comes the tricky part. Is this relay activated? We know first we need this circuit to be activated. We go back. Remember I told you one time, sometimes we have to start from this position and go back. And sometimes we go forward in a schematic. This is the case where we go back in the schematic. You don't always start from the top, from the battery going to ground. This is where the tricky part, like I said, is involved. I just asked the question, is this relay activated in the low position? We know we're going through three resistors. We're dropping the voltage as much as possible. Therefore, we're going through here, 87A, coming out 30. And to the blow motor, through the purple, at the blow motor and back to ground. The lowest possible voltage. Why? Because look how much voltage we lost across this resistors. Again, there is no value of resistors. But you can see as more, the more you add, the more you lose voltage across it. And the current, it will decrease. Again, so the question still arises. Why are we in this position, or is the current, or is this in this position? Remember, if this is activated, this is flipped from 30 to 87 now. Let's figure it out. What will cause this to activate? Guess what? See this? When this is in a high position. Only when it's in a high position, guess what happens? Current flows here, no connection here. Current flows here, and boom, activates this. As a result of that, what happens? Then this is flipped. When this is flipped, 12 volts is connected, boom, right to the blower motor. The blower motor gets the full 12 volts at a high speed. As I just said, the rule. Let's go back to the rule. If you want the high speed, you're going to get the whole 12 volts. You want the low speed, you're going to lose everything. You're going to get the lowest voltage. Okay? How does this help? When we went into low setting by putting low, we only have a choice of going this way. This relay is not activated. Only activated in the high position. This selector can only be in the low position when it's low, not in the high. That's the beauty of this circuit. Hard to understand, but that's how it works. Okay, let's go again. If you don't understand this one, you'll get it on the next two shots. Low, we explained. Medium one. Okay? Medium one, same thing. AC, go through here. Now, where's the switch? Over here. Over here. Not here. Do we have a path to go? Yes. Before, we didn't have a path. We were open here. So, we have a path. C4, going through here. M1 coming out here. And where are we going to go now? Where are we going to go now? Guess where we're going to go? Is it one resistor? Second resistor. And where are we going to go now? Same thing. right here. Why? This did not flip over. Why did it not flip over? Because we didn't choose the high. We chose medium one. Instead of three resistors, guess what? We're getting better. We only have now two resistors. What does that mean? It means we'll get more voltage here. The speed will increase. M2. Flip the switch where? From M1 to M2. Which position are we in now? The switch is in this position. Come over here. Come over here. Right? Which resistor? R3. This, only this resistor. These two are not in the picture. What did that do? That took away even less voltage. So now we're left with even less voltage, because here at medium one, we had more voltage loss. At medium two, we only have this resistor in the picture. Therefore, we only have this voltage to deal with instead of these two losses. So the voltage will get higher. What does that do? The speed will increase. You see the formula here? Lower speed, higher speed, higher speed, highest speed. The resistors determine the speed in series with the blower motor. Okay? Again, low, I will have all three of them in the circuit in series. Medium one, I will only have two in series. Medium one, I said two. Medium two, I'll only have one. Now, what I was saying before, we did low, we did medium one, we did medium two. We're left with only one more, high. We come over here, and guess what? Follow the orange. Now what happens? Now we activate the coil. When we activate the coil, guess what happens? Electromagnetic field flips this switch from 87A to where? To 87. And where is 87 connected to? Let me go out to this 12 volts. How much will this be getting now? If it's connected to the 12 volts, the full 12 volts. And what about that? What does that mean? That means if it gets a full 12 volts, it gets the high speed, the highest speed. What a beautiful circuit, isn't it? So, if we don't get the high speed, right? If we don't get the high speed, could be this fuse is not good. If we get the all these type of speeds, right? That definitely means that this blow motor resistor is good. So you have to figure out which speed you're getting it, which speed you're not getting it. If I'm only getting it on the low, I'm only getting it on the medium one, medium two, but I'm not getting it on the high speed, that means this relay didn't activate, didn't flip this, or the fuse. So ask yourself the first question, does it work on high speed? If it works on high speed, what does that mean? The relay is working. The fuse is working. I'm getting 12 volts to blow a motor. And then you work your way to the other thing. So, like I said, this is pretty tricky. But, like I said, as a request of a viewer to go over it, I hope this helped. Like I said, always leave comments, and I always get back to the comments. Now, the request that I have is to thank the people that I got monetized. It's a great accomplishment for myself. But anyway, as you know that I found out, you only get paid when people look at the ads. If you skip the ads, you don't get paid. So please do a request for me. Please try to watch the ads, especially the one that says 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let it just go, you know, fully, whatever it is. And that way I can get, obviously, more monetized to reach the goal, because you need $100 a month, the minimum, to get paid at YouTube. So if you could do that request for me, I would appreciate it. Just, I know it's inconvenient, these commercials you have to advertise, but right now, it, you know, that's what's paying the bills. So thanks for that, and I hope this was helpful. Please go to my channel, Joe Electronic Schematics for Auto, and my other one, Automotive Electronic Schematics for Joseph. Please go to a video that I did one time about the cables of the battery. Someone asked a comment about that. You can measure the cables, the voltage drop across the cables, the positive into the negative. But you have to crank or start the key, the ignition key. The other way that I did in a video that I showed you, if you're not going to measure the voltage drop across the cables, what can you measure? You can measure the resistance. If there's a good connection, meaning there's no corrosion, no rust. You will measure, and I showed you in the video, go to that video, from the post or the cable all the way down to the other part of the cable, the metal part of it. So you should measure around zero ohms, 0.2, 0.3, whatever. That tells you that cable will make good contact with the post. As I said, go to the video, how to measure the post or no start the condition for, for car or battery, and look at them. You'll see it. You'll see that one. Always measure the resistance of the cables before it goes to the post, because you will lose voltage drop across corrosion of those cables. They are high resistance, or any resistance. You don't want any resistance at those cables to the post. Okay, that's my own technique that I developed. I didn't have seen it anywhere else. Measure resistance, and you follow that one. If not, I'll make another video. Thank you so much, Arthur. Thank you so much, Sahih, for this suggestion. Thanks.